Hello viewers, and welcome to the very first episode of Persona TV. I am so excited to be here. My name is Andrey Kazak, and I will be your host, and I'm privileged to be here. Today we are in a brand new kitchen. Okay, this is opened in Roseville, California, called Scavolini. Today, here at Persona TV, what we are going to do is combine two very unique individuals and try to do a challenge. And before we jump into any more details, I know you're getting excited. I would like to introduce to you our very first guest. I hope you're ready. Please welcome Taro Arai. Thanks so much for being here. We are at Scavolini Kitchen. First, your first impression of the kitchen. What do you think?
It's beautiful. I want to rebuild my kitchen too.
All right. Kitchen. I see you got your setup here. Yes. You're good to go. I have a challenge for you.
Yes.
All right. And the viewers at Persona TV, we want you to do something for us. And I think you've never done it before. We'll talk about it in just a second.
Yes.
But first, please introduce what you've brought. Like, you know, I'm not a food guy. You are. What exactly, what kind of ingredients are out there?
I mean, these are typical Japanese ingredients, fresh wasabi, a little yuzu salt, and other stuff, but I brought salmon because all my friends who love salmon is from there. And also, I borrow all these ingredients from her too. So
from her, okay. Let's
who is her?
Who is her? Let's find out our guest, our second guest. Please welcome the lovely Tatyana Nesteruk. Tatyana,
oh,
hi,
it's
so good to see you.
Be here.
Okay, say hi to Taro.
So good to meet you.
I am matchmaking right now. Okay, here's what's happening, you guys. Our goal today is to combine what you do into one Japanese, Russian into Russianese. Russianese, right. It's the new cuisine. All right, so Tatyana, let's talk about what you brought out here. As you can see, salmon, Japanese ingredients. He borrowed some from you. What is this exactly right here?
So my culture, Eastern Europe, Ukraine, Russia. So I brought the ingredients for shuba. So this is like a potato salad with herring. So we have beets and potatoes and carrots and eggs. And this is the finished product. So Taro's gonna be using that to create a new roll.
And now these are all ingredients that were used for that.
Yes,
okay,
exactly.
Awesome. Okay.
Same exact thing.
And I think what we are going to do, dear viewers, listen, pay attention, okay? We're gonna have three different courses. First up, we're gonna start with appetizer. You know a thing or two about appetizer, about main course, about dessert, because you are the founder, the owner of Mikuni, Japanese restaurant. If you don't know, this is the man in flesh, this is him. Please tell us, how many stores, how many restaurants do you have?
We have only 9 so far.
So far,
and
growing.
It has been 30 years since we opened the first one, but our new goal is to open 50 in 50 years, so we have a lot more to go.
Are you guys ready for the challenge?
I'm ready.
Taro, do you think you can do it? Can you take these Russian dishes
yes.
and turn them into I don't know, maybe a sushi roll?
Russianese roll.
Russianese
right?
roll.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yes.
Dear viewers, strap on. Here we go. Round one, appetizer.
This is the most simple but most popular Russian appetizer. It's just simple crepes with a little bit of caviar. You could do black caviar, whatever type you like. A little creme fraiche. Perfect. It's really simple, absolutely delicious.
So without further ado,
just keep
let's do this.
Yeah.
We have
make
the ingredients right here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and make that available for you. And first
okay.
thing that we see here is salmon. Okay.
Yes, fresh salmon. And yeah, I go all over the world just to find the best fish in the world. So next month I'm going to New Zealand. I just went to Croatia to find
the
bluefin
tuna
farm. Oh, I love it. That's part of my
job.
It's a hard work.
Yeah.
You have to travel all over.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna use the ancient secret from China, salon wrap. Mm-hmm. It's a joke, okay?
Sorry. I was like, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm gonna put it in the box. And so I have to learn more about your ingredient. Mm-hmm. So herring. Is that very popular?
Herring, and it's a really acquired taste. And in Russia, we don't marinate it like here in the United States. You'll usually find it in the grocery store in like kind of an acidic wine sauce.
Okay.
In Russia, we marinate it in oil. So it's herring in oil, and there's like some onion in there, you know, just salt, pepper, really simple spices. But yeah, it has a really strong kind of flavor.
Okay,
to it.
So I put those herring in there.
Yes.
So this rice is from California. 100% of the sushi rice grow in Sacramento.
Wow.
In America, so it's
all
amazing.
Locally sourced. Huh?
And these potatoes, what kind of potato? Just a regular potato?
Organic potatoes from Whole Foods.
Okay, so we're gonna use that in there too, mm-hmm. to give the little soft taste here. And how about a little soybean wrap to put
this
it together?
This already looks so good.
Okay, Any other, if you have any idea, please let me know. Otherwise, I'm going to put
more. Oh, this is great.
Rice.
And then we're going to put some black caviar on top, maybe?
Yes, we have to.
It's going to look so good.
Okay, so use that.
I love this technique. I've actually never seen it before. So it's really awesome that Taro brought this in. Thank you for bringing it in.
Of course. You got to have fun and unique, yes. Right? Okay, so
it
now
does look like
this
a little
like a cake.
Look at that.
Okay, here you go. Okay, now I like to put it in the plate.
I'm gonna do a little bit of plating here.
Yes, and the topping is very important for me because I want to make sure I use Russian style.
Yes, and you mentioned earlier that you know Japanese cuisine is all about visual. It's all about eating
yes,
with your eyes.
Yes, that's what my grandma told me. Eat with your eyes.
Yes.
And then presentation is very, very important for Japanese culture. So now I'm gonna put a little bit of secret here.
Secret sauce.
Yes. And I'm about to torch because you're so hot, I gotta make it sushi
it's
hot
my
too.
My favorite tool in the kitchen.
Oh, me too, I love it.
So good. And it smells really good too, guys.
And let's see, this is a 7 spices we use all the time. And a little black, we call tobiko caviar. Tobiko. You gotta have that, right?
Yes, gotta have that.
And what else we should have? How about a little tomato? Do you eat tomato in Russia or no?
Absolutely.
Okay, good.
Absolutely.
I wanna make sure. This is a Russianese roll. I wanna make sure I put things that you like. And a little crunchiness to it. Okay, add the color. And then I need some green too. Can I still?
Yes,
those?
We have a little bit, some fresh chives.
Yeah. Okay. See, I love making sushi because you can be creative.
Yes.
You can make anything you want. And
that's what I love about being a chef.
Yes.
You know, working in the kitchen, it's so much fun because it's like creating art on a plate.
Right.
Which unfortunately then gets destroyed, but it's just, it looks so good and it's so much fun.
Yes.
Oh, that looks amazing, Taro. Thank you. Look at that. This is such an awesome combination of our two cultures.
I can't wait to try it,
yes.
though.
All right, here we go, round two. Ladies and gentlemen, take a look at this beautiful salad. Now, this has been voted by the Persona TV staff as the most popular Russian salad to ever exist. We have to have this on the show because this is a must. And honestly, I'm looking at it right now. It looks like a masterpiece. And I just can't wait to see what you could possibly do. Now, you're already working on something.
Oh, yes.
What is going on?
Salad. I got to make salad, too.
Oh, that looks amazing.
To make it more fun,
now, you know, one of my favorite things that and I order at your restaurant all the time is the poke salad.
Oh, poke salad, yes.
That's what this reminds me of, kind of. And I see you
a
have
little
some.
Sesame oil, I had to make.
Is this
Russianese salad.
Is this it? Is this what wow, this is amazing. And so here's what I'm gonna do. You have a lot of culinary background and whatnot. I want you to kind of go ahead and visually rate this.
You know what I really love about this salad? How Taro like put together the ingredients from shuba into here. So that's awesome. And shuba is like the most iconic Russian dish ever. And it's actually an acquired taste because there's fish in there. Underneath all this goodness, there's actually fish. Did we put some fish in here?
Yes, I did. Yeah. Your herring.
Yes, the herring, pickled herring. We have beets, potatoes, carrots, and this looks absolutely amazing.
All right, now I want you to take a closer look. Look at the comparison between the two. Two completely different dishes with same ingredients.
Right.
It's kind of like, again, you know, kind of like cultures. Yeah, there's a lot of differences. At the same time, there's a lot of, you know, similarities. We're going to take these. I see they already prepared the forks. There's only two. Hey, they better bring one for the host, too. I want to try this salad. So this is, we're going to taste this in just a second. But for now, we're going to do the final stage, which is the dessert. Mm. Wait, hold on. Are you putting strawberries in there?
Yes.
Oh,
everything.
Nice.
You guys. I'm still thinking.
Yes.
Unreal. Unbelievable. Taro, pause right there. Hold on a second. I just want people that are watching this to kind of see what I'm seeing up close.
Yes.
You have a roll with, yes. I see salmon in there. You have, what is this, Tatyana?
Beets.
Okay, we have beets in there.
And potatoes.
And strawberries.
Yes.
Okay. Strawberries. Now those, like, I mean, when you talk about, you know, beets, salmon, strawberries, somebody might say, ugh, what's going on? But I don't think that's the case. You are a genius, and I trust you. I think
she has amazing dessert. I said, I gotta have some dessert.
You gotta make some dessert, right?
I can't guarantee what the taste like.
Okay. We're gonna, that's why we're here. We're here to find out if it works. Or if it doesn't, let's find out. Now, and then what is this, Tatyana? You prepared some sort of...
a little extra custard. So homemade, creamy vanilla custard. Ooh. And that's what kind of keeps this whole cake together. So there's actually 12 layers of puff pastry in this beautiful, gorgeous Tort Napoleon. We need to put this in a dispenser bottle.
Yeah, can you decorate the dessert?
Oh, sure. We'll try to, you know, do something with it. Maybe if we can...
This custard
is like not really like runny, but we'll put it like that a little bit. Maybe I put a little bit of that crunchiness on there.
Yes.
Oh, it even looks like a dessert. Like it looks
it like
a little
like a dessert.
You know, like a little mini cupcake or something on a plate with.
Yes.
And here we go. This is the final product. Take a look. I'm giving you a full spin here so you guys can see that. Unbelievable. Now, okay, what is the topping here with the white
rice crackers?
Maybe
a little crunchiness.
They're like
to
little
it.
Crunch.
Yes. Okay, kind of like little sprinkles. Okay, yes. Out of everything that we've made, the salad, the sushi. I think this is the most experimental.
Yeah,
I think this is one thing that you will never ever really try anywhere. Okay,
yes.
Until today. So I think you guys, I think we did a good job.
Thank you.
I think. There's only one way to find out if it works or not.
Yes.
And we're gonna give it a rating. We're gonna see, does it work, does it not? And yeah.
Let's do it.
Let's
dig in and enjoy.
The first is the appetizer. I like how you guys swapped.
Yes.
Yeah,
on this side, you have the
other's.
Japanese. This is the Taro's creation.
This looks so amazing.
It's amazing, and I can see a little bit of this in
but
that.
But I want to try this too.
Yeah.
And you know
Let's
what?
Let's go.
We're not going to keep you waiting.
Okay,
Let's
good.
Go ahead and start with this.
All right, salud.
Nesterovia.
Nesterovia.
This is like such a great way to start off a meal. You're waiting for the main course. Have some blinchki with caviar, a little creme fraiche, a little something to drink, you know, perfect.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
So yeah. Let's compare.
Let's compare.
This is,
we have to try Taro's too.
Now, we're about to see, does it make the menu or does it not make the menu?
Let's find out.
Now listen,
out.
Taro, hold on. So this is Taro's new book here. And I opened it up, I read it a little bit, and I saw that you kind of have roles in here and you describe, you know,
right.
kind of what each role means and
right.
kind of, you know, the thought process behind it. But listen, what we're doing here right now, you guys, is does this Russianese role have potential to be the next book to be on the maybe even the cover photo. Let's find out.
Well, next book is ambition, so yeah, should be in
there.
Yeah.
All right,
ambitious.
Tanya, I'm gonna let you start things off because I wanna look at your reaction. I wanna see. And Taro, as she's trying it, go ahead and fill us in on the ingredients and exactly what went into making this.
Well, I did the herring, of course. That's your typical fish you eat all the time. Mm-hmm. And salmon, you do like it, and I love it too.
Mm-hmm.
And all the vegetables I borrow from you, beets, potatoes.
That's the first thing that kind of, my taste buds was the fish.
Right.
I grew up eating all the salads and everything, so for me, it almost seems like, oh, that's familiar.
Yeah, it has like that little familiar, and then you also have like a little bit of the beets in there, and then you have this amazing combination with the Japanese. You have that torch salmon. It tastes so good. This is definitely
because sardine itself might be a little too strong for some people.
Yes.
So I think this will miles up the flavor,
yeah,
balance.
It has just like the right amount. Yes. It has like that tiny little hint. It's amazing. This is a win.
Thank you. Thank
there
you.
We
this
go.
Is
very
a
nice.
Win.
A win is a what? 1 to 10. What are we thinking?
Let's say a 10.
It's a 10.
Thank you so much.
We're off
10.
To a good start.
We are off to a good
to
start.
A perfect start. All right. So that leaves us with
a salad.
let's move on.
Moving on to the main dish. Yes,
the main dish, let's go, come
let's
on.
Do it.
Taro, in front of you, you have a delicacy. This is a Russian favorite. It is called?
Shuba.
Shuba.
Shuba. Is there even a translation to that?
There is kind of a translation. Uh-huh. It's called herring under fur. So literally it means fish under a fur. So the herring is kind of like tucked underneath like all like the different delicate layers of veggies.
Even though you have like a beautiful outside presence, you know there's something on the inside.
Yeah.
There's something really good.
There.
And I know, so right now, first and foremost, Taro, I want you to try it first. I want to see, first of all, how you try it, how you eat it.
Yeah, how do you eat it?
Usually you kind of
mix it or just like a cake and eat it?
Yeah, it's kind of like a cake. You want to like get a little bit of everything. There you go, like that. See, and it's like nicely layered, so you have the herring, and then you have some potatoes, carrots.
I can see by his reaction, he loves it! All right, now moving on to this one.
Good.
Take a look at this one right here. This is, I see beets in there. I see literally all the ingredients from up here. Transformed into a Japanese version. All right, here we go.
All right,
if you don't mind, I'm gonna go ahead and give this a shot because my favorite thing on the menu at your restaurant is the poke salad. That's what I order all the time. Yeah. And so for me, I'm gonna.
Now, I was telling Taro, this is like art on a plate. It's just such a beautiful presentation. And that's what I love about this food. All right, let's give it a try.
Yeah, but I didn't make it too strong, very mild.
Mm. Oh my God.
Is that okay? Very refreshing, right?
What is the spice? What is the spice that you kind of?
Seven spices. There's different spices in there. It's just some oil in it.
This is like amazing, guys. Yeah. I would order this like over and over again at the
restaurant. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Whatever you sprinkle on top there with the seasoning, it just tops things off right there. Give me a rating on this Russian dish first and foremost. 1 to 10.
You know, to tell the truth, this is one of my favorite dishes now.
Really?
Oh my goodness.
You see how you took the plate? Like, I'm taking this home with me, okay? I'm out of here. I'm leaving.
Fish and I love beets now and just, I don't know.
That's the beauty of this show. This is the beauty of Persona TV.
I don't know who created this, but I have
two unique cultures, and we're loving it.
And it's such a beautiful symphony, because honestly, this is amazing, and I'm so glad that you enjoy this.
No, I love it.
It's an honor to hear that from such an amazing chef, guys.
This next one is the most experimental.
Yes.
The dessert! Okay, the dessert is the one that, this is the one I'm the most excited about. Taro's the most nervous about it because we have different ingredients in it.
Yes.
And so far, 10 out of 10. 10 out of 10. Let's see if the dessert can match it. I don't know. Let's find out right now. All right, here we are. We brought in the dessert. I like how Taro puts the cake right in front of him.
Yeah. Can't wait.
Going into this, Taro was the most excited about the Napoleon cake. Yes. He's like, this is amazing. I can't wait to get to dessert.
But we said,
Taro, we can't spoil the food. You know, you can't have dessert first. Okay, we got to save the best for last. So let's see what happens here. This is so exciting.
I'm sweating already.
Yeah, Taro's so nervous. And honestly, I'm excited. I love experimenting.
I'm excited to try it too.
Yeah. So. And just honestly, presentation wise, I'm not gonna lie, this looks really good.
The thing is, I don't think I had never heard anybody make dessert with raw fish in it. I think we're breaking every rules
time.
Out there.
Well, yes, so we're first time for everything.
Hey, we don't break the rules, we set the bar. Yeah, okay, we're doing something different here.
Yes.
So we have salmon in there, we have beets. But hey, before we get to this, let's try the original, okay? This is the original.
I'll take this.
All right, well, here's a pork plate you can eat right off the cake stand.
Ooh, I always wanted to do this.
Do this, hey,
I don't want to get in trouble, but I'm going to make a mess.
So, and while he's doing that, Tatyana and I were so familiar with this. This is such a popular cake.
I mean, you can't go to a wedding or an anniversary party or anywhere without having this cake. I mean, it's like the cake at any Russian gathering.
This is the one thing that I was the most excited about. And I know, Tanya, you're with me on this. You're sweating. You're really nervous.
Without
further ado, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. We're going to, please give it a name. Give it a name.
It's a strawberry salmon roll. There you go.
The strawberry salmon roll. Let's see if it tastes better than it sounds, okay?
All right.
Here, everybody, don't eat it yet. Just go ahead and pick one, roll up, okay?
All right.
And we're going to cheers.
Oh, I get the most custard.
I'm gonna get some custard.
Yes.
All right. Don't leave me out of this. Okay. Here we go. Oh, my strawberry.
Oh no! You gotta have the strawberry.
Okay. Here we go.
All right.
Oh wow.
All right.
Here we go. Cheers.
Cheers.
Bon appetit.
I appreciate the custard.
First thing I tasted was the beet. fit into the beat? Mm-hmm.
Beat, yeah. Mm-hmm. Little earthy first. Mm-hmm.
Okay, now listen. I don't have any culinary background at all. So as a, I'm from the perspective of me coming into a restaurant and trying this for the first time, knowing nothing about food. It's edible. I can eat this. No, I can eat this. This is good. This is good. And I like how it has savory and sweet.
Yeah, it's honestly not that bad.
If there is a mixture between dessert and food, this
but
is
you know,
it.
It's actually a really great balance because it's salmon is not overpowering.
Right.
And you have a little bit of the beet in there, which is sweet. Beets are just naturally kind of sweet, earthy flavor. So.
You don't mind if I go for a second?
Yes,
I feel like
please.
This is the kind of thing that you just... It's like, oh, that's interesting. I gotta have another.
I gotta try it.
I gotta have some more. Okay, yeah.
Second piece.
Or nice trying.
We did this for the previous round, so we're gonna do it again. We gotta rate it. We gotta give it a rating. All right, Taro, we're gonna ask you to rate the cake.
Okay? I mean, you can't go wrong with it. That's not fair.
Give it a rating.
This has been around for how many years?
Probably 60, 70 years.
60, 70 years versus a few hours. This is a brand new, this is, we're starting a trend here. And honestly, I know a lot of our viewers are, oh man, I wish I could try it. I wish I could try it.
I know, right?
Well, you know what? It's up to Taro. If he wants to put it on his menu, I don't think he will. But if he decides to do so, you know, you can just come into your local Mikuni and say, hey, can we request the strawberry salmon roll, please?
Yeah.
And per request, they'll try and create it.
Yeah. Ah, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
So
you think about Mikuni, if you find it, I'll make it.
Mikuni go out, they go out of their way to make their customer very happy. So I'll give it a rating. I fell in love with it. I'm giving it a 10. I love it so much. Honestly, I'm going to have one more. I'll give it a rating.
Honestly, I'm going to give it a 10 for ingenuity because Taro took these ingredients, brought it together to create a roll that's actually quite good.
You're so merciful.
And it's just like the flavors there are awesome and just amazing.
Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you for being a part of our very first episode. Wow, what a strong start. Did you have fun?
So much fun. I personally had so much fun. It was such an honor working with you. And Andrey, you're doing such a great job, you know.
Can we make more sushi? Can we stay here for another day or two?
Yes.
We have to wrap this episode up, unfortunately, but on the next episode, make sure you tune in. We're going to have so much more exciting things happening. But hey, before you go, we want to treat you. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being a part of this. And we have a little giveaway for you. I know you're probably intrigued. You know, if this video was fun, we would like for you to take something home with you. And this is Taro's brand new book, Appreciation. And then go ahead and show us your book.
And I have my very first cookbook. It's the European Cake Cookbook, 65 cake recipes in here, guys.
And hey, take a look right over here. Scavolini is throwing in a brand new knife set. Now, again, big thank you to Scavolini Kitchen. What a beautiful kitchen.
And amazing.
What an honor it is to be filming here. So you have a chance to take home these gifts. A brand new cookbook from Tatyana Nesteruk, and of course, from Taro, from Mikuni. And this brand new knife set from Scavolini Kitchen. All you have to do is like and share this video, and down below, comment your idea, your concept of your culture, maybe a dish from your culture combined with Japanese or the Russian culture, and we'll select the most appealing one, the one that catches our attention, and we will pick a winner. All you have to do, comment down below that idea, and good luck. Again, thank you so much for watching, and we will see you on the next episode of Persona TV.
Arigato!